I know a lot of you feel that you know something about binary, so I thought this is a relatively simple and compact topic that I might be able to make a relatively short video about. I want to start off by just doing a simple addition sum in the normal tens counting system that we use, just to remind you about things like how to carry a digit from one column into the column to the left of it and so on. First thing I probably ought to do right up at the top here, which is why I've tried to leave myself a bit of space, is to remind you, what do these columns mean? In this column is the units, always. It's the ones, if you like. And in the tens system, the one to the left of it is counting up the number of tens that you've got. And of course this one on the left is counting up the hundreds. The more you get into the mathematics of this, the more you learn that really and more fundamentally, 100 is 10 to the power 2. 10 itself is a 10 to the power 1 column. If we had thousands over here, that's the 10 to the power 3 column. So what's this one? Well, anything to the power 0 is 1. Even 2 or 3 or 77, anything to the power 0 is 1. Okay, so those headings, I hope, will remind you about what each column actually means. Now let's just draw a line here and do this addition. 5 plus 5 is 10, but if you get 10 in any one of these columns, you can't write down 10. The rule is that every digit in one of these columns can range between 0 and 9. When we come on to binary, of course, we'll be counting in twos, and the rule there is every digit you put down must be 0 or 1, but it can't be 2. So instead of saying 5 plus 5 is 10 and writing 10, if you recall, we put down a 0 and we carry a 1. You make a little note of it somehow down here. And then what you do is you say, well, in the tens column, I've got 5 tens in this number up here, 3 tens in this one, 5 and 3 is 8, 8 in the tens column. Ah, but I carried 1 over from here, so that's a total of 9 tens. There's nothing further to carry out from the tens column into the hundreds because it's in range, it's got a 9. So all you do is say, I've got a 1 there, nothing there, 1 plus nothing is 1. So the answer is 190. Let's do a binary example immediately below this decimal 1. So we're going to be in 4-bit binary from here on in, down here. So straight away, by analogy with what's gone on above, we can say the first column on the left will be 2 to the power zeros, then there'll be 2 to the power 1, then we'll have 2 to the power 2, and then we'll have 2 to the power 3. 1, 2, 3, 4 bits. Or, if you like, you can also make a note to yourself that 2 to the power 3, this is the 8s column. 2 squared, this is the 4s column. This is the 2s column. And recalling that anything to the power 0 is 1, this is the 1s, or the units column, is going to come on down here. Let's do the following binary addition. 1, 0, 1, 1. Plus 0, 0, 1, 1. So this first number we've put in here is 11 in decimal notation. The one in the row below it that we're going to add on, no 8s, no 4s, 1, 2, and 1, 1, 2 and 1 is 3. So all we're doing in binary is we're going to add 11 to 3, and we hope that the binary answer will look like 14 in binary. But again, let me emphasize that the business about carrying digits across applies with just the same ferocity in binary as it does in decimal. So this is what you do. You start off always on the right-hand column. 1 plus 1 is 2. You want to write down 2, but you're not allowed to. It's like saying 5 plus 5 is 10. You can't write 10, you've got to write 0 down and carry 1. Just the same here, 1 plus 1 is 2, but I have to put a 0 down and carry 1 as a memo to say I must remember to add that 1 in as well. Now, this gets really hairy now. You've got 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 3. Now, if you're not allowed to write down a 2 as an answer in this column, you're absolutely not allowed to write down 3. So how do you cope with this situation? You cope with it by saying, well, the 3 that has amassed itself in this column is actually composed of a 2 plus a 1 in this column. So the one left over you write down here, but that 2 now carries across as a carry into the next column on the left. I now find myself with 0, 0 and 1. Well, that's easy. That's just 1 in total. Finally, 1 plus 0, dead easy. So that's the end of that addition. You end up with an answer that's got 1 in the 8th column. We've got a 4. We've got a 2. 8 and 4 is 12 and 2 is 14. That's the right answer. Now, those of you who are desperately keen computer file types will know from Dr. Hartbleed's Why Gangnam Style broke YouTube, because it got 2 billion hits. The problem with that is it overflows a 32-bit integer. What does it mean to say you are overflowing an n-bit representation? Well, I can show that very easily, just what happens with the biggest representation that you can get in 4 bits, which is an 8 plus a 4 plus a 2 plus a 1, which of course is 15. What happens if you add 1 to that? Well, it overflows. Why? Because you do 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus that 1 is 0 and carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0 and carry a 1 again. 1 plus 1 is 0 and carry 1. Yeah, we've run out of space. We had a carry out, as it's called, from the 4th column across into the 5th column from the right. So we had a carry out into a situation, a column that didn't exist. And carries into columns that exist, as we've seen, you just add them up and take account of them. But if you have a carry out into an adjacent column to the left that doesn't exist, that's called an overflow. And you've got to be constantly aware that overflows can occur. It still prompts the question that if we did want to do negative numbers within a 4-bit constraint, how could we do it?
Actually, free software is a wonderful place to do that kind of work.